Magic and illusion is entertaining for all ages. Spectators are stumped by the impossible that happens right before their eyes. Reza is an illusionist from Brookings, South Dakota. And from a young age, he knew that he could make the craft a profession. You see, for Reza, seeing is believing.
I was 6 years old and I saw a magician perform at my elementary school, and it was just a really inspiring thing. So I asked my parents for a magic kit for my birthday. And so I would practice the illusions and show them to my friends and family. I think it was probably the reaction that they gave me, you know, to performing these tricks that I found the coolest, to be able to do something that an adult was fooled by and entertained by, you know. As a kid, that's a very empowering feeling.
That magician performing in Brookings Elementary School was the great Ondini, or Greg Ahmet, to his friends.
If you really love it, you'll stick with it. But it's not for everybody either, you know. You're pretending to do things that don't really happen, so I like to do that. I think kids are open to magic. Those are probably your best audiences because they believe it really happens. You know, as you get older, you become wiser, and people are not quite so open to the idea that magic really happens.
Right there, it's inside.
You're not really born with superpowers, but you develop them.
Oh! Reza understood that a career as an illusionist would take more than simple magic. Without the benefit of YouTube tutorials, Reza spent hours at the library reading tricks.
And then before I'd read The Secret, I would try and come up with my own method to do that. And then I would look at The Secret at that point and see if I had something different than what they had. And so I think that that probably was a very positive experience for me to have to dig a little deeper, for me to have to work harder to find these secrets than if it was just made very easy to me. The first gigs were just anywhere that they would allow me to perform. I would do shows for my friends' birthday parties, any place there's a gathering of people, you know, and I was in elementary school at that point. And so slowly those events grew from being paid with $20 and a piece of birthday cake.
Entrepreneurial at a young age, Reza knew that magic was expensive. He would need funds to buy props, later a trailer to haul equipment, and finances to pay his crew. In grade school, Reza started selling items door to door.
And so I'd go door to door and I would say, hello, my name is Reza, and I have a catalog here of things that I'd like you to look at and see if there's anything of interest. And they would ask me, what's this for? Are you going on a trip? Is this for your school or a fundraiser? And I would say, no, I want to be a magician, and this is how I'm funding it. I think that it was just cute enough to work, and just crazy enough to work. And now I have people come to the show even today, and they say, hey, I bought a candle from you when you were, you know, 8 years old.
While in high school, Reza had an opportunity to perform in Branson, Missouri, starting as an opening act, working with seasoned performers that could help hone his technique.
And then that led to an opportunity for me to actually perform within the show. And then eventually I had my own show on the Strip in Branson as the youngest entertainer actually in Branson at that point.
Reza returned to Brookings to study business at South Dakota State University. Much of the year is now spent in Branson and touring, but South Dakota is still home. Platte native Krista Chemnitz joined the crew as an onstage assistant while studying at USD.
Reza and I were friends for a while, and I perform on stage with Reza, and then along with that, I also help with some of the business side of things. I actually met Reza before I ever saw the show. But the first time I saw the show, you know, I didn't know the secrets, I didn't know how anything worked. Even though you maybe know some of the secrets after you've been working around it for a while, I still enjoy it because every magician presents it differently, you know, and Reza has his own style.
There's a lot of ways to eat an Oreo cookie. You're probably familiar with this. I'm curious, does anyone do this method, the twist?
Yeah, and the
eat inside. Yes, exactly. You know, I'm going with this. Here, check this out. If you eat the cream first, It's good, but then you're just left with cookie, right? So check this out. What if we could bring the cream back? Watch. Look. Just like that.
It's all about the entertainment, it's all about the audience. I don't want anyone to leave feeling that they've been tricked or duped. I want them to leave feeling like they had an experience that they wouldn't otherwise be able to attain. Leave all the stresses of work and school and come and just, no matter what age you are, just to feel like a kid again for a moment.
If you'd like to learn more about Reza, the Illusionist, stop by and visit our website.